Hello friends, I hope you are doing well. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to download, install and use Fujifilm RAW image converter. If you are new in this channel, you might consider to subscribe. I publish weekly tutorials on photography, editing and tech. Anyways, without further ado, let's get started. First, visit Fujifilm official website to download the software. Then go to the menu section. From there, click on support and then download software and firmware. And then click on software. The first available option is the RAW file converter software. Click on that. And choose the operating system you use to download the right version of the software. Tick the box to agree with the terms and conditions to proceed the download. It is a large file, so it might take quite a while to finish the download. When download is completed, install the software as you install other applications.
Right, so now we are going to import an image to edit, and I will give you a short tour so that you will have some basic idea about this software, how to use it. So to import the image, go to the menu section here and then file. From there, open file. And I am going to import this image to edit. This is a JPEG image. However, if you have any RAW images from your Fuji camera, you can import similarly from the file locations, but I have JPEG here, so I'm just importing this. Also note that if you have RAW images from other cameras such as Canon camera, that won't be opening in this particular software because Canon has different RAW file format like CR2 file format, so that won't be opening in this particular software. Please bear that in mind too. But other formats like JPEG, common formats, those files will be opening in this software, and you can edit them initially before going into further editing with other softwares. So let's open that. So when it will be opening, then you will have some information of your image here at image properties section. If you don't have that image properties option here, then go to view. And then from there, select image properties. And then there are other options too, like navigator. You can select from there. And then you can change the view mode here. When you'll be editing, then you will have these undo and redo options. Now they're not working because I haven't touched the image yet. And then you have other options here like exposure bias tool, and then gray balance tool, and then black level tool, and then you also can rotate your images here. So basically we will be working here, like we need histogram, we need parameter controls. If you don't have these options here, you similarly go to view menu here, and then from here select these options like histogram and then parameter controls. So here, as you can see, this image is not looking perfect because of the color and everything else. But if you want to change anything, like for the histograms here, they have some settings which you can use. Like, you know, if your image is like street pictures or landscape or whatever, portrait, then you know you can easily use these settings and it works well. So it's a different type of picture. So I'm just selecting something randomly. Let's see how it works. And then if you're not happy, you always can increase and decrease the histogram. And you can also change the color mode here. All right, and then we have white balance option here, where you can go with some auto settings, or you can customize your settings down here. When you will be selecting any of these options, you will have some options here to customize this here. And then we have a tone section here, where you also can go with some specific settings, like if you want a bit more contrast in the image, you can go with a little strong contrast. If you want even stronger contrast, you can go with stronger contrast. And then we have color section here. From here you also can go with some specific options like portrait, film, color, BI, B2, all this. And also you can play with this options here, like you can increase the saturation. And then we have sharpening option here. You can similarly choose some specific settings. Or you can play with these options here to get your desired sharpness in the image. So friends, this is how basically you can edit your images in this particular software. And initially we need to just correct certain things, like when you see the histogram, you see the problems, whatever the problems and things you detect on the image, you can then increase the color tone, increase the sharpness, and all these things before going into detail editing. And this is how it helps us to initially, without damaging the image, improving the quality. And then, because if you directly import those images to any other editing software, it's likely that we can't do much with that. So this is why we we can take advantage using these kind of softwares. There are other options too. It's not only the raw file converter from Fuji. There are other options too, like Darktable. Anyways, now I'm going to show you how to export the file. When your editing is completed, then go to file section here, or development section here, or you can use shortcut command S and then develop. So from here you can change the setting. So you can change the basic settings like file type and then the file output. You can choose the options here, like let's go with high quality here, and if you want TTF, you can do that as well. And then the JPEG setting, you can change it too. And then we have other options here, like you can use different unsharp mask here, and also you can manually increase and decrease the unsharpness of your image. Whenever you are happy, just click on develop, then a new image will be created for you. So friends, these are the two images we have. Like this is the primary image, and this is the image we touched. You see the difference here. And now I think it would be easier to edit with this image rather than going with the previous one. So friends, this is how you simply can download and install RAW file converter software, and you can edit your pictures before going into detailed editing. I hope this tutorial will help you. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Goodbye.